All right, I want to talk a bit about Moses, because Moses is very important to American law, because the United States operates on three premises. One, Roman government. Our government is Roman in style. Our philosophy is Greek, and our laws are Jewish. And so Moses is very important to the laws of America, the Mosaic law. So let's look at Moses, because it's a very interesting history about the real story of Moses, the lawgiver. We know that Moses was given the law by God. He's the lawgiver and the leader of the children of Israel. And supposedly God gave Moses the Ten Commandments on Mount Sinai, and he comes down from Mount Sinai bringing to the children of Israel the new law. The Ten Commandments also, of which Moses is supposed to have gotten from God, the Ten Commandments are actually based on the Egyptian negative confessions. Do some research at the library or on the web on the subject of Egyptian negative confessions. And you'll find that the Egyptian negative confessions was the laws in Egypt, and they're almost identical to the Ten Commandments. So that's probably where we get the Ten Commandments, is from Egypt. And here's just a classic example of the comparing the Egyptian negative confessions to the Hebrew laws from Moses. So the Mosaic Law. Moses, the lawgiver. All right, we have Moses, the lawgiver, in the legislative chambers of all across America and all the states. In the federal government, we have statues of Moses being the lawgiver. Not even mentioning, of course, the Vatican and all over the world, Moses is respected as the great lawgiver. Supreme Court, you see Moses holding the two laws, the tablets. Interesting, too, is that Moses, when first given the law from God, threw them down and broke the tablets, so he was the first lawbreaker. This is where we get the idea that you break the law. As I said, here's Moses, the lawgiver, depicted in the U.S. House of Representatives. Why does Moses have horns? Now, I have some interesting questions about Moses. Let's start with his horns. A lot of people don't know that Moses was always pictured with horns. This is in the Vatican. In churches, you will always see Moses, anytime he's portrayed, you'll see him with horns. Moses is pictured with the moon or lunar horns. Moses was the focal figure of an ancient cult of moon worship on the Sinai Peninsula. The horns represent the crescent moon. The moon in its lower quarter resembles horns. As this encyclopedia talks about, the lunar phase when the horns of the crescent moon point up at the angle. So the horns are actually the moon in the lower quarter. And we'll see the god of the moon, his name was Sin. We'll get to him in just a moment. You'll see the goddess is wearing the moon horns. Native Americans, of course, Native American chiefs wore horns. This is why they would count their days. Native Americans would count their days from sundown to sundown. That's why they would always keep track of their days by many moons. They would not say many suns, but by many moons. So the horns of the Native American Indian chiefs were the lunar horns of many moons. And, of course, the Vikings kept the same identical idea. The Vikings had the moon horns. And it was, as I said, the lower quarter of the moon was in the shape of horns. And so, establishing that the lower quarter of the moon, the horns, now we get into the actual archaeological findings. We see the moon being pictured on coins. Here's hands raised, worshiping the moon. These are ancient findings in archaeology. Here's the moon on its boat as it floats through the sky in the ancient Egyptian idea. Here's the Virgo, the Virgin, the constellation of Virgo, connected to the lower quarter of the moon. The moon god above the three in the middle. So the lower quarter of the moon has taken on the appearance of horns. And here you'll see the same thing in the Vatican. The Vatican, lower quarter of the moon. The moon cults. I'm not going to bother to read all of this because you can read it yourself, but it basically is talking about an ancient cult of the moon. And, of course, in Islam, Allah is connected to the moon cult. Now, if you go to the Google, for instance, if you go to Google and type in moon god Sin, because the actual name of the old Arabian moon god, was his name was Sin, S-I-N. Sin was the Semitic moon god's name. So as I said, if you go to Google and just type in moon god Sin, S-I-N, you'll see there's over 1 million entries just on that one subject. Then if you put into Google, say, S-I-N, equals Allah, you'll get about 1,270,000 entries talking about the moon god Allah. And here's another one. This one's like 3.25 million if you put in moon god Allah. So Allah, or Sin, S-I-N, was a moon god in ancient Arabia. Here's another one. You put in Islamic moon god, you get 198,000 entries. Here the Catholic Church even uses the crescent moon. As I said, the moon god's name was Sin. Sin, the moon god, was a god chiefly venerated in the pre-Christian civilization in southern Arabia. It is significant. The lower part of this paragraph, it says, it is significant that the Semites of the great caravan city of Palmyra in the first three centuries of the Christian era also gave high priority to the worship of the moon. And there it again, we see that the moon god's name is Sin. Now, one dictionary, or actually it's an encyclopedia on symbols, talks about the moon god Sin. It says, if Moses climbed Mount Sinai to meet the resident god, then the god he met would have been the moon god Sin, who had been enthroned on that mountain since the rise of Sumeria, and gave his name to it. In fact, Sin gave his name to the whole Sinai Peninsula, formerly the land of Sinim. So originally, Yahweh was not only a form of the primitive lunar deity of Arabia. So Yahweh, the god of the ancient Hebrews, is actually the old god of the mountain, Sin, the moon god. Says in Babylon, homage was paid above all to the moon god, the supreme guarantor of cosmic order. So we see this, here's another one, another cuneiform picture from the ancient Sumerian showing the god Sin receives the homage of two of his worshippers. You'll see the moon in the lower quarter, and that's the moon god Sin. And as I said, in the ancient Arabian, a system of moon worship, a mountain was Ai. So you take the mountain Ai and connect it to the god Sin, it becomes Sin Ai, or Mount Sinai.